God, nanotechnology cannot take you to God. But nanotechnology can take you to God. If you misapply it, it can not only take you to God, it can take a lot of people to God. If it is not properly handled, it will create a whole rail system of compartments and engine to the divine kingdom. Nanotechnology cannot create divinity because it is understanding of matter. You see, how many idiots? They may be equal to one wise person. So I am putting 100 idiots here. That is one wise person. So if it is not there are 200 idiots, it is utterly different because wisdom is different from idiocy. The mass can be equivalent, but not the qualitative mass. Quantitative mass can be equal. Likewise, matter at any degree of subtlety, at any degree of expansion, it cannot give God. God is not matter, he is paramaterial. So it cannot give, but God, as he is the encompasser of material, semi-material, anti-material, paramaterial, subtle material, tangible material and all other modes of the world, he can give you knowledge about the nanomaterial if you want. But with the knowledge of Max Planck, I told you, with the knowledge of these things, we can understand. You see, if you see a painter, that is the painter, you can understand about his face and other structures, that we can have an inference that he may paint very properly or beauteously. But if you see a painting, then only we can understand the elegance of the person's nature, his dexterity. Likewise, the more you deal with nanotechnology, you can understand how deeply the creation has been made by God. If you are already God-fearing, it will make you God-loving, and God-provoking, it will make you to reach God.
Thank you, Mahaji.
As a tool for testing your patience, I want to put a few words as my epilogue. When I went for this computer and brain lecture at Symbiosis Auditorium, I was talking about all parts of brain and all parts of computer, their interrelativity, convertibility, etc. And I believe that except some of the people who have the habit of just listening to me, whatever I say, irrespective of the faculty, somebody they have taken that fanaticism. So unless those people, those who have some interest with me, the other people I have been saying that they are blinking like stars and owls. So that's how I consider for effective dissemination process. Then I gave also two humorous examples. And one thing is, somebody is very hungry and he is approaching us. I have to either give food or rice so that he can cook and eat. So I am making the person to sit and describing about agriculture, irrigation process, pesticides and other things, number one. And second thing is more humorous. Hundreds of patients they are coming with different gifted diseases. The doctor, he has made all the patients to assemble in a common hall. And instead of asking about the diseases, he is explaining about anatomy, physiology, and comparative study between the heart of your frog and human being, etc. I myself quoted this and I gave two suggestions. Interactive session, for example, even in brain and computers. I told a very simple example, number 31, for example, let it be Jubilee Hills, 31 is post office, 32 is hotel, 33 is theater, 34 hospital. By knowing these points, we can go and get whatever the product available there, benefit available there. Likewise, I have told about the brain centers like Broadman areas, phrenology of Joseph Hall, and Jerry Fodor's modularity of mind, everything you know. By knowing the brain centers, what you are going to, for example, somebody will be having phobia. Mechanophobia is in operation. Then communophobia is in communication. Anglophobia is in English, chemophobia in chemistry, arithmophobia in mathematics, physiophobia in physics, biophobia in biology. Everybody will be having a lot of xenophobia with the new people. And lot of other phobias, bibliophobia with books, theophobia with God and persons like me. So each and everybody will be having a deep-rooted fear. So unless we customize the questions and teaching, no doubt general lecture is required. But it must be very limited, and whatever that is applied for them and immediately getting to some sort of application, use for them, that we have to give more accentuation. That's what I felt on that day. Then I told that we can keep for 10 or 15 minutes general lecture. Then before we must give them a prior information, intimation, so that they will draft their questions and we can discuss, number one. Number two, I am taking classes, teaching chemistry, teaching physics, teaching mathematics and teaching biology. How to teach them? And how to read the early syllabus. So I am going to teach at some schools at Chennai. Likewise, all this same nanophysics I am going to teach for BE people at SNR College at Coimbatore. So I want three types of programs with anybody, generally what is it. General topic for 15 to 20 minutes. done previous intimation to the people so that they can look other books, think and develop their own questions. And even if they may be knowing things, they can have further clarifications or they can clarify me. So they can trap these questions at present, number one. Point two, instead of talking about something like America is doing that and Italy they are researching that and Japan, Tokyo is doing that, that is just information. And for proceeding, what is the starter, where is the point of ignition? So I must deal with your syllabus. Your syllabus, you have to give a heading and your teachers are going to teach. Let me teach the same lesson in my own angle of perception, which will be deeper, I think, number two. Number three, net discussion group we can make. I'm having my email ID. And whenever you have doubts, you can put your doubt. And whenever I'm having my free time, I can just give you answers. And that will also improve your knowledge. And even if you are attending conferences, that will enrich you to ask more questions and to follow lectures, not only from me, and also in future lectures where you are going to attend or organize.